Welcome to the first video dealing with the tool called ModProCon, which has been developed in the framework of the BoulderXCE project. This video introduces the online training course to use ModProCon. In this video, we are going to provide a brief introduction about ModProCon, what are its objectives, and the operating mode of the tool. Finally, we will give the structure of the tutorial and what will be explained in the following videos. So, what is ModProCon? ModProCon is a model-based decision-making tool for emerging contaminants. We are not going to model flow and transport processes of emerging contaminants or contaminants of emerging concern with ModProCon, but we want to provide a tool to guide the users towards performing solid transport model and field measurement for investigating fate and transport of emerging contaminants in the environment. The tool of ModProCon was developed through the active participation of stakeholders within the project, which means that we took into account their feedback and their suggestion in order to make this tool an easy to use support decision making system for water management. The objectives of ModProCon are twofold. The first one is to show to water managers that it is important and possible to try detecting pharmaceuticals and personal care products, in short PPCP, in drinking water sources and in general in, let's say, in the capture zone of drinking water sources. And the second objective is to raise awareness about the complexity of the problem of pharmaceutical and personal care products, the difficulty of collecting enough data in order to build a reliable model that is able to tell us whether or not PPCPs can enter the drinking water system, and if it is possible, considering the data availability that we have, to develop a model that is able to predict the fate and the transport of these substances in the environment. Among pharmaceuticals, we can mention hormones, antibiotics, beta blockers, and so on. Among personal care products, we can mention disinfectants, antimicrobial agents, and for example insect repellents or fragrances. All these chemical species are generally found at very low concentration in the environment. This makes a challenge both for laboratory facilities as well as for modeling to properly describe their behavior in the environment. Where do these substances come from? Well, very often it's not really from a leak from the manufacturing factories where we can detect the source of these contaminants. On the contrary, we have a lot of secondary sources that can contribute to the presence of these chemicals in the environment. Such sources can be, for example, hospitals or households and leaking sewer systems, or treatment in wastewater treatment plants, which is not sufficient in order to degrade these chemicals. Other sources can be aquaculture treatment and livestock treatment facilities, as well as septic tanks and landfills. These different sources can lead to the presence of PPCPs both in groundwater, including a car system and porous aquifers, for example, as well as in surface water body. Finally, these contaminants could also enter the water supply system, and it is therefore important to be able to detect them and describe their pathways towards the drinking water supply system. ModProCon aims at estimating the probability to detect specific PPCPs in our system. We classify, therefore, the different PPCPs according to this probability as PPCPs that are very unlikely to be detected in a drinking water supply system, unlikely, likely, or very likely. And according to the classification that we perform, and as we will see in future videos, this classification is based on the chemical properties of the substances, we can decide if a model is needed or at least recommended. A model means a mathematical tool that is able to tell us when and at which concentration one of these PPCP could be detected in at a point of interest. After the estimation of the probability to detect a certain PPCP, as we said, which is based only on the chemical characteristics of the contaminant, we provide guidance to gather relevant parameters in order to develop a solute transport model. Therefore, we move, let's say, to a general context, to a specific condition for the case study, in order to design also field measurements to collect the missing data. Therefore, we provide to the interested stakeholder suggestions how to collect the missing information in order to be able to predict the possible occurrence of PPCP in their system. We provide therefore a list of data which are generally needed in order to set up flow and transport models, and we provide an availability check. If the data are available, then the model is feasible. If the data are not available, then ModProCon will provide both the reason why the data is needed in order to build the model, so to motivate the user to collect this information, and we provide also a suggestion how to obtain this data. Very often it will not be a duty of the stakeholder to perform this kind of field analysis. Nonetheless, we want to motivate them in order to get in contact with local experts, either the Environmental Protection Agency, a university, or a company, in order to coordinate the collection of the missing information and the development of the model. Finally, the implementation of model-based measures to mitigate the risk to human health and the environment is recommended as a tool to improve the situation and as a tool to manage a possible critical situation. The development of ModProCon is based on the pilot action that have been considered in Boderek C project. We have in the project 8 different study areas which have been subdivided into 3 clusters. Surface water cluster are case studies in which the drinking water resources derive mainly from surface water bodies. Karst water are case studies in which the drinking water derives mainly from a karst system. Finally, with groundwater, we mean those case studies in which drinking water derives mainly from porous aquifers. Those case studies are divided in different participating countries of the Central Europe Interreg area. And therefore, we had the possibility of collecting the opinion of different stakeholders in different countries with different needs and different sensibilities toward the problem of PPCPs in the environment. And we tried to include their feedback into the Mod ProCon tool. The operating mode of Mod ProCon is based on two different steps. In the first step, we performed an analysis according to the water source. So the user, first of all, is asked to select which water source is of interest, whether it is groundwater, surface water, or a karst water system. In the second step, the user can select the pharmaceuticals and personal care products of interest for the case study. In this database, we collected important chemical information that allow us to describe what is the probability to detect a PPCP in the water system. The result is a classification for the PPCPs which have been selected by the user in terms of probability of detection, and we subdivided the different species into four classes: PPCPs which are very likely to be found in the water system, likely, unlikely, or very unlikely. In case the PPCP is likely or very likely to be detected in drinking water systems, then it is recommended to perform the data availability check and eventually to develop a model in order to be able to predict at which concentration and when a possible PPCP could enter the drinking water system. The data availability check will guide the stakeholder towards the solution of the problem and to the decision whether or not the model can be built. In case the model will not be built, it will try to provide suggestions to the stakeholder in order to overcome this issue. The contents of the MOOC of this course related to Mod ProCon are the following. First, we will provide two tutorials related to the first analysis and the second analysis that we just described. Therefore, we will go into the details of the selection of the sources for drinking water extraction, to the list of the available PPCPs, and the chemical physical properties of the different PPCPs. In the second tutorial, we will present how the indices are generated and how the probability is estimated. In the third tutorial, we will describe how the data availability check for setting up a transport model will be developed. Then we will present three applications related to the case studies of the project Bodrex Sea, with a surface water body, a groundwater body, and a karst aquifer.